I would like to introduce my next guest. It's just some author ho. Welcome to the show, you harlot bitch.
I am really esteemed to be on your show, Dan. It's truly a privilege.
Right, let's get to this. You are already boring me with your limited knowledge of sports and lack of enthusiasm for my man parts. To start off, what is your book called?
Thank you. It's always nice to hear compliments about my book. It's called Female Pattern Baldness, You Are Not Alone. It's actually a semi-biographical tale.
That sounds so exciting. I may just shoot my load right here and now.
I'm not sure that would be altogether professional of you now, would it?
Let's get to the questions then, shall we?
Righto then, Emoliers.
I disagree with your assumption. I would say you're all ass. I digress. Allison from Albuquerque, New Mexico asks, if you could be any 1950s cultural stereotype, who would you are, and which?
Well, that's a very good question. I think there is more pressure on women to look their best, and I'm just trying to reassure all the ladies out there that there are others just like you who feel your pain.
Roberto from What's the Matter You? Hey, why you no respect? City, Italy asks. I like pizza.
If I could change one thing about my body, it would probably be my fifth nipple, for I can deal with butt five and you're fucking pushing it, mister.
Okay, that's very relevant. The next question is from Jeff. Cut open your scrotum and use it as a carry case for your lucky billiard cube, from Boise, Idaho. His question is as follows.
Sorry, can I just stop you there?
No, you can't. The question is, I saw your camel toe in one of the gossip magazines. It looked like two tectonic plates had violently collided, causing a mountainous plateau to form with a huge cavernous gap in the center, where not even the most intrepid of sexual adventurer would dare to park the bus. Comments?
Yes, I think it is very important to use public transport whenever feasible, even if it does smell like a crack-addicted baby's shitty umbilical cord on the subway. It's all about living responsibly and keeping your emissions as low as possible, even if it means sitting in a seat covered in cow discharge and pensioner turds. Sacrifice, people.
I probably should not say this on the air, but I wish you would choke on dead parrot beaks. That is how much thought I have been able to give my method of killing you, and how I would manage to get my hands on parrot beaks. I have even drawn up a draft suicide note and contemplated who to blame when the police find your giant lifeless ass floating cheeks up in Robert De Niro's bathtub.
I actually don't have that complicated a process when it comes to setting a scene for my novel. I am so easily inspired by everyday occurrences, like just yesterday. I was driving my car through Brooklyn and I noticed an albino Indian folk musician fisting a paraplegic altar boy dressed in a Ronald McDonald costume with authentic red pubic hair, while watching reruns of Friends overdubbed into a Congolese tribal dialect. I just thought to myself, what a vivid image that is. You know, inspiration is everywhere.
Wow, you're a real hypocritical bitch, aren't you? I thought you said that you use public transport.
Public transport is for peasants and Renaissance fairy enactors. I would not at risk contracting vaginal warts sitting on a bus, thank you.
And that's about all we have time for. I guess there is a God after all, and oh is he ever merciful. Good night.
My book hits the shelves June 29th, US, July 9th, United Kingdom. Thanks for listening.
This is a television program, but whatever. I would not be surprised that you thought this was a radio show, as you seemed desperate to make yourself look as much like a Yemeni fishmonger's weekend wife as was possible with your meager budget and fashion expertise.
Is it wrong that I'm wet right now?
Well, kind of, because it isn't raining. Just because the ceiling is blue, doesn't mean that you should confuse it with the sky. Although you did confuse this with being a radio show despite the abundance of cameras and the fact you waved to the audience at the end. Oh wait, you meant, oh my god, excuse me while I puke my balls at the thought of your parasite-infested snatch. Not to mention the fact that you seem to be completely oblivious to the subject matter of the questions. I don't know if it was all for show. like German citizens denying all knowledge of concentration camps, or sincere stupidity, like Sarah Palin confusing North and South Korea.
What's a Korea?
A new brand of discreet incontinence pads. Butlet is a non sequitur. I'm going home now. I hope that you are impaled by midget jousters on the way home. Good night, America.